I didn't realize that essential oils needed to be diluted. I would take peppermint oil neat and I would put it on my hair. And then I would have like an intense tingling sensation and I'll be having a headache. And in my mind, I was like, yes, it's actually helping my hair grow. I didn't know I was damaging my hair. Welcome back again to The Style of Success. I'm Kelly, and on this channel, we are all about beautifying our bodies and minds. So if you are interested in scent or style, then you are in the right place. Now, are you aware of the fact that your hair strands are actually dead? It is so vital and important that you take care of your hair scalp, because once your hair has grown out of the root or the scalp, there's not so much you can do in terms of trying to make your hair grow thicker. All you can do then is to give it some shine and sheen and just make sure that you're not having breakage or split ends. Now, this is a disclaimer. Essential oils are not the only things you need for hair growth and thickness. To make your hair actually grow thick, then you have to take care of your scalp, you have to take care of your hair, you have to take care of your body. Let's talk about essential oils for hair growth and thickness. Now, in recent times, I found out that essential oils have been getting a bad rap. The reason is that most of the time, essential oils have allergens in them, and people react differently to different allergens in different products. Now, the word perfume, a lot of times, has been used to hide some unwanted ingredients in skincare. And because of that reason, a lot of people avoid anything that has perfume when it comes to skincare products. Now, I'm not going to go into the controversy about essential oils or fragrances. However, a lot of essential oils were used for medicinal purposes. And if you've watched any of my other videos, you would see where I mentioned the fact that aromatherapy has been used for healing purposes, to help people to heal different ailments and different issues. Now, essential oils are well loved because they are natural products that come from the plant, and they have a lot of aroma and beautiful scent that we can use to scentify or beautify our body. Now, we know that we cannot use essential oils for like cooking, and you cannot just use essential oils neat. Essential oils need to be diluted in a carrier oil in order to be used. And I'll talk about that later on in this video. But let's talk about these essential oils that we need that have been researched to actually help boost hair growth. Now, the first essential oil I'm going to mention is rosemary oil. And as the name implies, it's actually derived from the rosemary plant. Now, rosemary oil is very good at helping to stimulate your hair follicles, which will help to result in like stronger and longer hair. Now, rosemary essential oil is also said to help promote better blood flow to your scalp and to your hair follicles. It also has a soothing sensation that can help to relieve like an itchy scalp or a flaky scalp. It can help to treat dandruff. Now, the rosemary oil is a strong oil. It's sort of minty, but it's a nice herbaceous scent that is so good. It has a bit of woody notes in them. Now, rosemary essential oil blends very beautifully with essential oils like lavender, thyme, basil, and cinnamon essential oils. Now, the next essential oil that I want to talk about is lavender essential oil. I know some people are not very fond of the scent of lavender. Some people say it reminds them of old people. I think in the older times, a lot of women used lavender. So when people smell the scent of lavender, some people feel that's an old woman's scent. I don't think so. I think lavender essential oils are amazing essential oils that are really, really great for your hair growth. Now, lavender essential oil is very good to promote like overall healthy hair. And it's also really good for your hair shaft. Now, your hair shaft is the part of your hair that can be seen above your scalp. It is made of like proteins and keratin. And there are three layers of your hair shaft. You have the cuticle, you have the cortex, and in certain cases, you have the medulla. Interesting. Now, lavender oil is quite good at balancing the natural oils that are produced from your hair scalp, and it is great for all hair types. It has antibacterial and anti-inflammatory properties that are actually good to help to soothe your hair and just to help heal various issues. For example, it's actually said to help nourish your hair and protect your hair from fungal and bacterial infections. Some people have actually found that if you are struggling with baldness at certain parts of your hair, that it's good to massage lavender oil to the parts of your hair. For example, if you're losing your edges, but bear in mind that As I've mentioned before, lavender oil or any essential oil needs to be diluted in something, in a carrier oil. Lavender oil also has a sweet, flowery scent to it. It's also herbaceous and has a bit of like woody notes in it. So it blends quite nicely with florally or citrusy scents. So think about maybe like patchouli or vetiver or cedarwood. By the way, if you are enjoying this video, do click the like button. It helps the YouTube algorithm share it with those who are interested in this topic. And if you haven't subscribed already, do consider clicking that subscribe button. Come on, click it. Now, the next essential oil we're going to talk about is ylang ylang. By the way, I actually went on Google to learn how to pronounce this because I used to call it ylang ylang because I didn't know how to pronounce it. This essential oil comes from a tree that is native to countries in Asia, for example, Malaysia or India. And it has been used in these parts of the countries as traditional practices to help to improve your hair growth. This essential oil is quite a versatile essential oil because it's also said to help to promote smoother and softer skin. It has tonic and antiseptic properties, so it helps to promote the scalp health. It's also quite good at restoring balance to oily scalp so that the scalp doesn't overproduce oils when it comes to your scalp. So ylang ylang, like other essential oils, help to promote better blood flow to your hair strands, and also it helps to nourish your hair follicles and hair growth. Now ylang ylang, because it is intensely sweet and it's just a lovely scent, it's also widely used in the making of perfume. Now ylang ylang essential oil is one of those florally and sweet essential oils. It also has a slightly spicy, sweet note to it, and it blends well with essential oils like vetiver, like rosewood, like jasmine, and actually rose essential oil as well. Now let's talk about vetiver essential oil. Now vetiver actually comes from a common plant that grows in India. So vetiver essential oil is actually derived from the kus grass or kus. I don't know which one it is. Kus. It's actually known in India and in aromatherapy as a tranquility oil because it has a calming and soothing effect on the mind and the body. Now, the cooling effects that you get from vetiver oil is actually great at helping to prevent hair loss, especially hair loss that is related to high body heat. Now, vetiver oil, just like ylang ylang oil, is also good at helping to control excess oil production from the sebaceous glands in the hair. Now, by the way, if you're looking for what sebaceous glands are, I just checked Google. It's an oil-producing gland that is present in the skin of mammals. So they're usually attached to your hair follicles, okay? And they release a fatty substance, sebum, into the follicular duct and onto the surface of your skin. So it's an oil-producing gland, just in case you're wondering what sebaceous glands are. It's also researched to be good at helping control acne. I haven't tested that out, so please be warned. Now, the smell of vetiver is quite earthy and woody, and it has a sweet undertone as well. Vetiver also blends very well with essential oils like jasmine, patchouli, sandalwood, lavender, and ylang ylang. Now, the next essential oil we're going to talk about is chamomile. Now, I love chamomile tea. I was actually drinking chamomile tea earlier on today. Now, chamomile actually is derived from a flower. I think it falls under the flowers in the daisy family. It has anti-inflammatory, anti-itching, anti-allergenic, and antiseptic properties. And it is great in helping treat scalp problems like acne and eczema. Chamomile oil is also said to add a beautiful sheen and shine to dark hair and actually gives some nice highlights when it comes to blonde hair. So overall, chamomile is good at helping improve the luster and the softness of any hair type. Now, chamomile essential oil gives you more or less like a blend of sweet and fruity and herby aroma. It blends really well with geranium, rose, lavender, and jasmine. Now let's talk about peppermint essential oil. I always use oil of peppermint if I have a blocked nose. I always sprinkle like oil of peppermint on my pillowcase or around me just so that I can get that nice, minty, fresh, clear smell. Peppermint is amazing when it comes to stimulating blood flow to your hair roots. And your hair growth actually starts from your hair roots, as I mentioned earlier. Now, having more blood flowing into your hair means that your hair is getting more nutrients and it's getting the oxygen that it needs to produce new cells that will help to create more growth and multiply the hair shaft and help to develop actually good and healthy hair. So that tingling sensation that you feel if you've diluted peppermint oil in a carrier oil and put it on your hair scalp means that there's blood actually flowing to your hair. By the way, let me mention, when I first heard about essential oils for hair growth, this was several years ago, I didn't realize that essential oils needed to be diluted. And so I would take peppermint oil neat and I would put it on my hair. And then I would have like an intense tingling sensation and I'll be having a headache. And in my mind, I was like, yes, it's actually helping my hair grow. I didn't know I was damaging my hair by trying to apply it directly to the hair. So it shouldn't be giving you any headaches. So please do not be like me. Make sure you dilute your essential oils. Now let's talk about tea tree oil, which to me is very similar in scent to peppermint essential oil. But tea tree essential oil is actually very good at helping to add moisture to your hair. It is said to have antibacterial, antiviral, and antifungal properties that helps to keep your scalp free from infections. Now, tea tree essential oil helps to unblock the oil glands that are located close to your hair follicles. And it helps to encourage a well-coordinated flow of natural oils that moisturize your scalp and your hair shafts. Also, it's said that tea tree essential oil has some natural cleansing effects that can help to promote your hair health. So tea tree oil, just like peppermint essential oil, is herby in scent. It's a minty, fresh, clean, green scent. And tea tree oil can also be mixed with essential oils like peppermint oil and used to help to relieve dandruff. Now let's talk about lemon oil. Lemon oil is a very good essential oil for hair growth and thickness. It's actually especially good if you have oily hair. However, bear in mind that lemon essential oil is not good if you have really dry hair. Lemon oil is also researched to be a very good effective treatment for things like dandruff or head lice infestation, or if you have an underactive sebaceous gland. Now, and lemon oil is also a herby scent and also smells like the lemon fruit as well. I love actually the smell or the scent that comes from lemon oil. And last but not least, we have the essential oil called myrrh. YouTube has been great at helping to teach me how to pronounce some of these essential oils. But myrrh can be used as a substitute for lemon essential oil because it's also good for people who have too much of oily hair and just want to help to get that antibacterial and antifungal properties. It's a good oil to help to treat, you know, dandruff as well, and also if you have underactive sebaceous glands. So these are essential oils that you can add to your hair care regimen to give you healthy hair, healthy scalp, and just overall improve and promote your hair growth and thickness. Now, the guidelines for diluting essential oils is anywhere from 1% to 3% of the entire formulation of the product. But normally it's at optimum at 2%. Sweet almond oil and jojoba oil are very good carrier oils that you can actually use to dilute your essential oils. And they're also great carrier oils that actually help to promote healthy hair. So make sure if you're diluting anything that you're measuring so you know the exact amount that you need to put. Anything beyond 3% is not really recommended when you want to dilute essential oils. So I hope you've learned more about essential oils that would be good to help promote your hair growth and thickness and actually just make you have overall healthy hair. By the way, in our Ethnique Hair Oil Elixirs, you will find that we have used a number of these essential and carrier oils because we know that it's going to be great to promote hair growth. And so if you are looking for a good hair oil elixir for your hair, for your scalp, then do try out our Ethnique Elixir Extraordinaire. We have two different types, one for extra dry hair, and we also have one for normal, medium, or oily combination type hair. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, do smash that like button. I'm going to link some more videos that you can watch that has to do with like natural hair and maybe some more on scents and style. But take care of yourself, and I will see you in the next videos.